man, I really didn't expect this, that we'll face a life like this, that too just sitting at home due to lockdown. As you all know, this deadly disease corona has taken place all over the world and it has ruined our economy, even our dreams, what we plan to achieve this year. Everything went in vain. Welcome back to the channel after very long time. So I hope everyone of you is doing absolutely great. I hope everyone is safe and staying at their homes right now due to the current scenario happening from past 2 to 3 months. I don't need to explain anymore about this. So once again, sorry guys for uploading videos very late. But I am embarrassed to say this again. From past 2 to 3 videos, I'm saying I'll try to upload videos once a week, but I'm not able to keep up my word due to some limitations and timings and all. So most of you messaged me to review the laptop which I purchased almost 2.5 months ago, almost 2 weeks before lockdown. But unfortunately, I was unable to make unboxing video of that due to unexpected purchase. So my dad already selected this laptop. I had the plans to go with the ROG, but unexpectedly I went with this one. So I think most of you have seen the disclaimer in the beginning that I am not a proper tech expert or a proper tech reviewer. Whatever I have experienced with this laptop, whatever specifications I know about this laptop, so I'm going to share that with you all. Even I looked for the reviews of this laptop on YouTube, but hardly I could find only 1 or 2 videos. Then I was in a bit confusion ki kya ye only just 2 videos are there, after which I got to know this model was launched very recently. So I hope this video will be useful for you all. So that's why I am making this video. So it's time to reveal the laptop. This one, this is my laptop. And the model name of this laptop is HP Notebook 14S CR2000TU. Just watch the cinematic looks of this laptop. So I hope you like the cinematic part of this laptop. If you do like it, make sure to watch the video till the end and make sure to drop a like because it gives me motivation into 100. Anyways guys, jokes apart, just to have a look of the specifications of this laptop. So I hope everyone is able to understand. Now we will have a look at what are the accessories that we get with this laptop. So this is the first free accessory that we got with the laptop. So this is the original backpack by HP, and the quality of the backpack is also really good. I'm impressed with the quality they have provided for the laptop pack. Really impressive, man. And if we talk about the second accessory that we got free with this laptop, this is the second free accessory that we got with the laptop. So this is the wireless mouse. This is also by HP, and I don't use that trackpad mouse and all. I mostly use this. Third is actually not the accessory, so I'll show you the charger. It's always free with the laptop. So almost with all the laptops or mobiles, you get the charger, man. It's common thing. So this one is the charger. Sorry for the tangled cables. This one is the 65 watt charger that they have provided. Now if we come to the first impressions of the laptop, by the physical looks, man, it's really solid. Build quality is actually good. Bottom is, I think it's metal. Upper part is the plastic. Build quality is really great. It reminds me of Apple MacBook. Almost it's lightweight and compact and easy to carry anywhere you can carry it. I think this will fit in the big envelope very easily. Really, man, I didn't see this much of compact. I have seen more compact laptops than this, but this one, according to the size, it's really lightweight. It almost reminds me of Apple MacBook as I mentioned before. But in performance, I can't compare this, and in the pricing also, there is huge difference. If you want the feeling of Apple laptop, then you can definitely go with this one, seriously. And if I say about the purchase, from where did I purchase this? I purchased this from HP showroom Nehru Place. Actually my dad purchased this one for about 56,000 rupees. If you are staying in Delhi NCR, then I would definitely recommend you to buy laptop from the Nehru Place. I don't recommend online, but if you are still interested in buying online, I'll put down the link in the description, so make sure to check that out. If you you are interested. So let's start with the review of this laptop. So first of all, we'll talk about the physical looks.
So we'll start with the front. So on the top, 720p HD webcam. And talking about the keyboard, it's a backlit keyboard. So just check this once. You can adjust the brightness as well. So this is off. And on the top, speaker grill, and here's the power on off button. So as it already mentions, i5 10th generation. Now if you see on the left hand side is the Kennington lock, USB type C port, SD card slot, and these are two indicators. I don't know what's the light for that. Now if we come on to the right hand side, microphone plus a headphone jack, just a single jack, 3.5 mm, USB type A 3.1 port, same USB type A 3.1 port, two USB 3.1 port, and this is the HDMI port, RJ45 port, and the charging port. And on the bottom there is a one more speaker with Windows branding, and let me just keep it like this. Here it's having one rubber pad, and same here as well. So this one. Now we saw the physical looks of the laptop.
Now the second part comes is the display and the speaker. So as I mentioned in the specification part, that it's having full HD IPS WLED display with the resolution of 1920 into 1080 pixels, and the display quality is really amazing to my personal experience, because I watch most of the YouTube videos on this, because as you all know, YouTube mobile video is restricted till 480p only due to the current COVID pandemic situation. So I'm able to stream HD and full HD videos on this very easily. And talking about the speaker quality is also really amazing. It's having that dual speakers, and it's really superb, man. Speaker quality is really superb. I mean, you should watch this sample. So I recorded a sample as well, but here again I am going to say that the camera doesn't do justice. It will just give you a bit of an idea. Here is a sample for you. So I hope you found that useful. Now if you come to the third part, which is battery, it is also an important part in the laptop. So talking about the battery life, man, I am really happy with the battery life they are providing. Even they are giving 65 watt charger, as I mentioned before. First, if we talk about normal usage, it gives me almost 5 hours of backup when I make documents, PowerPoint presentations, even if I watch YouTube videos in between. I'm continuously multitasking, it gives me around 5 hours of battery life very easily. If I say that if I play GTA 5 on this, it gives me battery life around 1 to 1.5 hours, because it takes more battery. This is a heavy game and it extracts battery a lot. And if I tell about the charging speed, charging from 0 to 100 in my average experience that I have faced is around almost 2 to 2.5 hours, which is really impressive. We come to the fourth thing, is this useful for students or office employees? Definitely this is made for students and office employees only. So you get the Microsoft pre-installed on this, so for the lifetime you get Microsoft free. So I actually got Microsoft installed from there only, from the showroom. Currently I'm using Microsoft Word document, and the PowerPoint both are really performing really well. If I talk about the fifth thing, is this useful for content creators or video editors? It's definitely useful for them, because I'm using Filmora 9 for editing my videos. I have Adobe Premiere Pro as well in this, but I don't know how to use that. That software is little bit of complicated, so I hope I learn that soon. For video editors, it's definitely yes, but I have to tell one thing here, that I'm shooting this video for the third time. Actually, I have shot the video, but due to editing issues, glitches, so first time there was hang, video was blank in between, and the second time what happened is audio was totally gone out. I hope during editing this thing doesn't happen to me a third time. So I uninstalled and re
reinstalled that Filmora 9 again, and now I think it should perform good according to the expectations of me. So if you are a video editor, then you can definitely go with this because it's having i5 10th gen processor, and for talking about the graphics card, it's having Intel UHD integrated graphics, and definitely you can go with this one for if you are interested in video editing. So last part if we come is the gaming. So mostly I think you were waiting for this. I play GTA 5 on this laptop, and truthfully man, I can't believe that I can play GTA 5 in HD graphics on this. My mind was totally blown. So currently I have 3 games on this laptop, and these 3 of the games are really heavy games. So first game which I have is Just Cause 2, second is WWE 2K20, and the third is GTA 5. These are the 3 games which I have in my laptop. And talking about the response from Just Cause 2, game I played in low graphics as well, it lags a lot in the HD and the full HD. Please don't ask, really fed up with that. And if I tell about WWE 2K20, man, it's worse, really worse to play on this. Totally I don't understand how to play WWE 2K20. And if I tell about GTA 5, really man, no words to say. Just see this sample video, you will understand on your own. The gameplay is smooth in HD graphics and the low graphics, but I can see little bit of sometimes if the battery is low or this if there is little bit of issue, the game lag little bit, not that much. I'm playing GTA 5 from past 1 week until now, I didn't face any issues with the game. So you have to see with your own eyes, but if this had external graphics card, then gaming performance and the experience would have been better, man. Seriously, my experience would have been more better. Just watch at this sample video that I shot. So there you go, bhai, my GTA 5, I am playing GTA 5 on this. So you can just watch at the gameplay. I hope you have seen that how GTA 5 performance is there. But if I try to play this in full HD graphics, then it lags a lot. But if I play in HD or HD graphics or basic low graphic, performance is really good at that time. No words to say for that. So with I hope I covered almost all the specifications and what are all the basic necessities of the laptop. So yeah, I forgot one thing. Now let's come to the conclusion. Should you buy this laptop or not? Definitely, if you are a student, if you want to edit videos, if you are just entertainer, multitasking person, then you can definitely go with this laptop, and even for the office employees as well. For content creators also it's good, and for the gamers I really don't recommend this laptop. But if you are satisfied with GTA 5 with low or HD graphics, then you can go. So anyways guys, I hope most of you found this video helpful. I hope I covered all the points. If you have any queries, you can question me in the comment box, so I'll try to answer that. But as I mentioned before, whatever I know, whatever the truth I know, whatever I have experienced with that with this laptop, I can tell you that, because I'm not that good at the technology reviews and all kind of stuff. So anyways, I hope you found the video useful. If you do found it useful, make sure to give it a like button, man, because it gives me a lot of motivation into 100. And if you have any suggestions or feedback, make sure to put it in the comment box, so I'll try to implement that. Anyways guys, it's time to end the video, so I'll see you in the next video very soon. Take care.